Thank you very much, David. So, you're our prince among men.
Okay, then.
You're doing some lesser goals?
One more, just a little bit.
Some lesser goals. They're all lesser goals.
That does it.
All right.
So a 3 or 4 doesn't equal one.
So, hey, Julie.
Uh-huh.
I understand you're thinking about a future.
Yeah.
How far is it going?
Oh.
Now that you're thinking about it.
Yeah.
Am I in the way?
Well, I find myself reminding myself that I
should.
No,
now that's where you go from the should to the could to the would to the must.
Right.
What a step.
Yeah. So I'm kind of looking for situations to set up.
Good.
Do a little teaching.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Saturday morning.
Oh, that would be today.
Right? Yeah.
Oh, I can show you how to do the half and half.
Yeah.
So what do you have in mind?
Oh, do you have mind in mind?
Thank you for reminding me that today would be an opportunity.
Yeah.
When I either should or could or would or
yeah. Matter of fact, I'm sure in this group.
Yeah.
There are people who'd like to receive the teaching.
Yeah.
Wait
a minute. I'll want to bet on it?
No.
Because you know there are.
I was going to win a nickel or something.
I kept trying to get her to bet.
Actually, I got to go cut something right now.
All right, go ahead. Come back with an answer.
You, Julie.
Okay. Oh, thank you.
All right.
Okay.
Did you put those in?
Yeah.
So then I started reading. So yesterday I put the Oxfordy pictures on my paper because I wanted to write.
Good.
And this is the paper. Hang on, I want to say too. Yesterday I was pissed off at everybody but you. So when I declined to sit next to you, it was because I was pissed off at everybody. So while I could sit next to you, I couldn't sit next to anybody else. So I had to go sit by myself. I wanted to make sure you knew that.
Yeah, okay. Yes, I heard, I got the rumor that you were pissed off.
that some rumor kind of moving softly and gently.
Yeah.
Demurely, one might even say.
That's not Barbara. She doesn't have those.
Oh, God. So, yes, I do. Would be another way of putting that. I was writing all the Oxford Adventures, and the curious thing I found was, this is the other piece of news, that even though I did the Oxford pictures like 40 years ago, 50 years ago, 40 years ago, 45, something, I didn't understand it. I didn't relate to it, couldn't get to it. You know, it was just like logic in a way. It was like words on a page. So when I went back to the Oxford pictures and they sent me into the Basui's lecture on the one mind,
yeah.
You know, I was going, wow, not only, I can actually understand
sense.
This.
Yeah.
And critique it.
Oh.
Ooh. So that was through the course of studies I've been doing with you. So that led me to reflecting on the fact that here I am reading the Oxfording pictures when I was pretty sure, a couple of writings on the self by someone you might know.
Mm-hmm.
So, APPA. I was reading the APPA journal.
Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, and because I have to include the highest.
Yeah, go ahead.
No, I mean, I just thought,
no.
So now I'm not angry. Conclusion.
Yeah, but you see, it was a great...
Yes?
It was a great point you're reading.
Which
point?
That's a real breakfast.
Oh, yeah, do you want a real breakfast?
Ah, okay.
That is.
Thank you.
Oh, you're sitting there.
Kolachi.
There's 3 different kinds.
What is it, though?
Okay, it's egg and potato and bacon or sausage or tomato. This one has tomato.
All right.
And cheese and egg.
I've never seen that thing before.
Where's the potato bacon, egg potato bacon one?
Oh, you are.
That's what I'm dreaming
of.
Did you do this?
No, I bought them. I bought them at the Kolachi factory in Tustin.
Ah.
It's a Czechoslovakian orange meal. I don't know.
That looks like tomato, doesn't it? I'll try this one.
Okay. You want to try one?
What's it called?
Kolachi.
Kolachi?
Uh-huh. Is it Italian?
No, it's Czechoslovakian.
Oh.
Polish, or Eastern Mediterranean.
Mm. Thank you, ma'am. Is it real meat? Mm. Or?
Yeah.
Okay.
You were at a key point. Where you were exploring the Oxherding pictures and you raised the subject of the self.
Yeah, well.
It's likely that you're thinking of doing a parallel to the Oxherding pictures using the idea of the self, aren't you?
Well, you know, they claim that the Oxherding pictures are about the self in the translation. Right? In 1 and 2 they talk about seeking the self.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah. Not only that, but yeah.
Yeah. You're thinking of doing it.
Yeah.
Good.
Relating it to what? I missed the whole thing.
Oxherding pictures.
With?
Self.
What way with self?
Well.
Comparing it with
something?
I think
you know, right? Because, I mean, just because, only because the Oxherding pictures is a set of steps, right?
Oh, just the Oxherding pictures themselves, not in relationship to another work?
The self. Pierre's work for himself.
Oh, well, that's different. You hadn't said that, so that's why.
Well, I'm not sure exactly what.
Oh, Pierre's work on himself.
Yeah, that's
different. Well, I don't know if that's where it is, actually. So that's probably why I didn't put it that way first. I've been working on that question myself, and I talked about before you got here, I think, about reading recent, jumping into Pierre's paper on the APPA, as well as I have some dialogues of his, as you do, that mention the exploration of the self. So when Pierre said, had I thought about making a comparison, my first answer was just yes, you know.
Yes, yeah,
that
I thought that was just brilliant. Yes.
And I'm included in what the discussion is. I wasn't clear what that relationship was. That's cool. That's a good idea.
Coffee. Because I suspect by the time I get back, you'll have once again drawn Julia into this discourse.
Well, I doubt it.
I could be wrong.
Get her.
Julia's been working on goals lately.
That's exactly why he would be doing that.
Yeah.
Typing up those transcripts takes a lot of time, but it sure is worth it.
I'll bet you a nickel that if we raise the subject with David, he'll be right on top of it and say he's among those that would be most interested in hearing your exploration. What do you think?
I think it's true. He would.
Hey, David.
He could have, should he?
Have you thought about perhaps exploring the idea of getting into the brilliant light of being?
Yeah. Well, I kind of bugged my eyes out because when you said it, it's like, well, that's the point about everything I try and do. Although I'm very bad.
Wow, I like that.
Yeah. Good.
I'm horrible at it.
Good.
But
in the same way.
Yeah, it's important.
Bill,
yeah.
Are you in it?
I haven't been until just now.
I'm working on it. I love it.
Well,
whenever I can get
suppose
a chance.
Julie happens to have a couple of good insights on how to get into it as a result of your own explorations.
Go
Would you
it.
Not like to hear about it?
I'd like to hear about it. Might
and perhaps been. Consider that she's playing a great role that's needed for us all?
Yeah. That would be the best part.
See? Do you have a group?
Ultimately,
yeah, come on.
What does this have
yes?
to do with me?
Yes.
Yeah. Say on. You into it?
And into the brilliant, what was it, the brilliant light of being?
Or? Yeah.
The end, exploring the idea of it.
Yeah. You
yeah.
Seem to like
or the idea
interested.
Of getting into it.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah, no. Yes. What have you charged? Perfect. So, say, at your leisure, why don't you think about an hour? What do you do to get into it? Then we might be able to borrow it. Get on to something parallel to your experience so that we can perhaps sneak along the way.
You know, this whole thing is, I don't know how this got started, this rumor that I even got into the brilliant light of being.
Hold it. That's okay. Let me ask you another question.
Oh.
So Say, do you like getting into sin?
Yeah.
Why? What do you get into?
I like that empty state.
Oh.
Being basically lazy. I have nothing to do.
Yeah, but you like that empty space.
Yeah.
Empty space. Say, David, is it sometimes said that beyond the brilliant light of being is that empty place called nothingness?
Yeah, yeah.
Would you be equally interested in that? Look, look.
Better than...
Even better?
Better.
Higher.
More. Whoa. So.
You too?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Shoot.
No, don't shoot.
So go ahead. What do you notice? How do you get into it?
Well, I go for the hara.
Ah, the hara.
And get centered.
Yeah.
I get my breathing going and I'm...
You're always breathing. So what kind of breathing are you talking about?
My diaphragmatic breathing.
Oh, okay, that's clear.
Nope.
No? Put a few more words on
it. It's a word on it.
Come on, diaphragm. Go ahead.
I could go for the Greek. I go for the friend.
Go for it. Go ahead. How would you describe it?
My breathing is in the hara area, down in my diaphragm area, instead of up here.
Yeah, okay.
And I just take control of my breathing.
Oh, wow. Look here. What does it mean to take control?
I start pushing my belly out and bringing the air in.
Oh,
and then pulling the belly in and the air goes out and I get that going.
How long does it take you to practice this that you slip into the...
About 2 seconds.
About 2 seconds, see?
Not bad.
That's pretty good, right?
Oh, 2 seconds.
David, what would you like to know about this?
It doesn't seem like it has anything to do with breathing if it only takes 2 seconds.
Right, well, when I get my focus there, when I remember to go there, then I'm there.
Mm-hmm. And once you're there, go ahead.
Then I just can stay there.
When you say stay there, do you notice some obstacles you might have to deal with? I stay there.
Yeah.
Well, what kinds of things deal with? Put aside in order to stay there. Example, did you have any psychic interruptions or thoughts or images?
Some or ideas or something.
Or tangents, as we call them. And how do you deal with them?
Well, then I'll go to, asking myself a question.
Oh, good.
What is it that sees, thinks, and hears?
Yeah, like what?
Like that.
Like
what? What is it that sees, thinks, and hears?
Oh, you like that.
Yeah.
And that
it's
helps.
Kind of my...
That's your...
My life raft.
That's your life raft. That coupled with the breathing you just talked about and, that sticking the belly out business, that's very Tibetan, isn't it?
I don't know.
Okay.
I thought it was human.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, it's also in North Korea. Mm-hmm. I mean, in Korea.
Oh.
Have you ever been in Korea?
Well, I learned that as a Zen practice up in the L.A.
Ah. With Papa Maizumi?
Well, one of his...
One of his people?
People. Then they taught me how to breathe.
Ah. Could you pass a couple of reflections on? They taught you to breathe. Did they say anything other than what you just said?
Well, I've also studied it in books.
Did you find any of them worthwhile?
Well, the idea that, when you make your belly go out, it creates a vacuum that causes the air to come in.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so you're not really even breathing, breath is just coming.
Mm-hmm. That helps.
And then when you pull your belly in, the breath leaves.
What books were you thinking of?
Oh, some yoga books.
Like?
Oh, I don't know.
Okay, just... You were going to reflect on what books?
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, you know, the yoga tape that I use with, what's his name? The yoga guy who you've mentioned before from the 60s, 50s and 60s.
Not Hittleman.
Hittleman. Hittleman even. No. Talks in that no. language when he talks about sitting and breathing.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
Those ones. He also had the books.
Right, right.
You got into those books.
Yeah.
Oh. You still happy?
I don't know.
Okay, okay, okay.
I have some tapes of his.
I have the Yoga for Health book, the old book that was going around in 1966.
That's probably it.
Yeah. But, but it doesn't talk a lot about breathing in that book.
Okay.
State of emptiness within 2 seconds of sitting down and doing something.
So do you ever do breathing when you sit? Is that
That's what I usually do, that and fantasizing.
Yeah.
A lot of fantasizing.
Is one more effective than the other?
fantasizing is very, very, my fantasizing is very strong.
Hey, all right.
Which builds more thumos?
Yeah.
So,
how long, ideally, do you sit when you sit? When you get into that state? How long a period of time?
An hour.
Oh. Is that the book?
And sometimes longer?
No, usually an hour is sometimes shorter.
Sometimes longer?
No.
Hittleman.
An hour. But, so, I mean, I'm not without fantasies, too.
No, I wouldn't have believed that. I thought the fantasies, but how does it relate to your sitting when the fantasies occur?
Well, I don't know. I mean, when I realize I'm in a fantasy, I bring myself back.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
But then I'll get back into my breathing and just
You said
myself.
Usually 1 hour. That's
yeah.
It. That's it. And I asked you, are there other times when it's more a longer period of time? What would be the longest period of time? Do you recall?
No, I don't. Seems like an hour was...
Yeah, you keep going back to the hour, which is why I was wondering.
Yeah.
Yeah. How do you know when it's an hour or so?
I check the clock.
Why do you check the clock?
Because I'm ready to stop. And I check the clock as I'm getting out.
Why do you have to check the clock?
I don't have to.
Because then you come out of it with the clock, don't you? If you come out with it, you want to be on time, so you come out of it after an hour.
No, I come out of it when I'm done, and I check the clock and I say, well.
How do you know when you're done?
Oh, that's a good question.
That's why I asked you.
Well, I just say done. I'm not like a muffin in the oven.
Mm-hmm.
No.
It's done.
No.
No.
Much more like a cheesecake.
A charcuterie.
Go ahead.
No, that's always a good question when I'm done. Oh, Pierre.
Come on, how do you know when you're done?
I'm going to record this because it's a good... How do I know? Pierre. Roasted enough. I don't know. This is a question, a perennial question.
How do I know when I'm done?
Yeah.
I don't know. I have other things to do, or but actually, sometimes I get worried.
That
if I sit any more.
Yeah. Maybe I'll. Go ahead.
Something might happen. Yeah.
That's right. What might happen? You got it.
I'd disappear or something.
You got it.
I don't know.
You think you'll disappear?
Yeah.
And that pulls you out of here?
Yeah.
What do you think of it?
I think it's kind of weird.
It is.
But
what's it called, that kind of fear? Or worry?
Sounds like a counterattack.
Oh, mm-hmm. Then you might be close, it might be interesting at 1 hour. That you're close to breaking through on yet another level.
Right. Yeah.
Now, so what's it like at that hour, 5 minutes before the hour is up? What's it like? What are you encountering?
I don't know about the 5 minutes before.
But you did say it very well a moment ago.
Stop when I...
Yeah, because you're afraid nothing. Come on. You might just... Go ahead.
Disappear.
But disappear?
Yeah. Or die or something.
Die.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yes, you do. It's your experience.
I guess I don't have any reason to keep sitting. So it's like, if I don't have any reason, then I'd better stop.
I don't know. Therefore, why stop?
Okay. Well, because I'm not making any progress.
Pardon me. You know you're making... Oh! You reached a crisis point, you're saying. You think you may die. That's true. That's true.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. You know, to go further, you're going to... Yeah, you're going to die. You're absolutely right. Hey, the fear is right.
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
True.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like, how do you know when to stop doing anything, right? Like playing the piano or stuff.
No. When you're really playing piano or playing anything, how do you know when to stop? That's not the question. Why stop is the question.
Right. Why stop?
Not why do you know you have to stop.
Why stop?
Right, we're changing the question around, aren't we?
Mm-hmm.
Right, so go back to the question. Right? You realize that if you go further, you may drop dead. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. You're right.
Yeah. Or lose sight of myself.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Facing nothingness, you're going to lose yourself.
Nothingness. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You're right.
Hmm.
But that doesn't explain why you want to quit. All of those things are right.
Because I get scared.
Of course, because of that fear.
Mm-hmm. So while I still have something, I'll stop.
Yeah.
Well,
that's enough. Hold it. Say it again.
While I still have something.
Yeah, where did you get that idea?
I don't know. It sounds like a gambling kind of
statement. Yeah, it is.
Statement.
Yeah, who talks that way at home? Concept.
Yeah. Stop while you're ahead or something.
Yeah.
Stop while you have. But this is pretty bad. This is stop while you still have something.
Yeah. Who talks that way?
Hmm.
Mm-hmm. Say, how are you going to deal with that fear?
Although my father was a gambler, so probably.
Oh, your father was a gambler.
He had a reputation.
And a reputation for that. Yeah, did he know when to quit?
No, he did not know when to quit.
Mm.
Hmm.
So you don't want to be like him?
Probably.
So you're going to know when to quit. Then you won't follow his example. That's possible. But let's just go back to that
disaster.
Fear. Yeah, what do you think of that idea now, that fear? Have you ever talked to that about that to Neil Bond? You ever say, hey, what about this? I get here and I worry about death disappearing. Have you ever talked to him about it?
I don't think so, but I can imagine what he would say.
Go ahead.
He would say, just keep sitting.
Well, that's what he says about everything.
Right.
Right.
Yeah. So.
Would you have liked to have asked him, have you been there? Did you have to go through that? What if you asked him? Yeah, what if you asked him that?
I don't know.
Yes, you do.
Oh, we could say, yeah, I've been there.
Then you could then vouch for the fact that he's a good man and he's already gone through that.
You yeah.
could take confidence in that.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
But you didn't ask him.
No.
Well, then you can't use him as an example.
No. How about yourself? You said?
Oh, yeah.
And?
Yeah, I've been
Do
there.
Do you recommend it?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
All right. You're still alive?
Oh, yeah.
Are you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Is that helpful?
Nope.
Because?
Because I still have to wonder about myself.
Yeah, you might disappear.
And, see how that goes. We'll see how it goes with my sitting.
Yeah.
But I'm still concerned about this reputation I have of this brilliant light of being and my entering.
Well, we got something better. You're into that nothingness. We'd right, David?
Oh, that's right. We wouldn't be
way,
on
way beyond.
Way beyond it. So don't worry
okay,
about
great.
That. We got a better reputation now.
Cool.
The hell with the old one.
Yeah, that's passé.
Yeah. So there's only one way you're going to face it.
Head on.
Yep.
It sounded like there was
yeah.
one other idea there.
Go ahead.
She said she wasn't making any progress.
Oh, yeah, progress.
And that's why she decided to stop sitting.
Yes, yes.
At that moment.
Yeah, because she
yeah.
hit that wall.
Well, this,
well,
you know, doing
know.
Nothing,
no.
you know, I start feeling bad about
bad
that.
Bad about that.
Like, I feel like I should get up and do something.
Well, that's your teacher. You always have to do something for someone.
Yeah.
Yeah, now you got to do something for yourself.
Yeah, see, that's where it gets...
Uh-oh.
Well, doing nothing for myself.
Oh, that's even worse.
Yeah.
Oh. So you're going to go ahead. You're going to go right into the whole history of your family.
Mm. Yeah.
And your role. Is that right? Hey, what
yeah.
would it be like, Julie, if you gave up that trip? Excuse me, that way of living.
Mm-hmm.
That you have
well,
to do something for other people. And not even do something for yourself special, just do nothing. What would it be like?
Well, I think it would be insightful, filled with insight and...
Insightful?
Yeah.
Hmm.
A lot of reflection.
Wow. Is that a better state? Would that be a higher...
Well, yeah, and I have some goals, some things I want to write, so I'll probably make some good progress in that area.
Yeah.
Thinking about myself and my own ideas.
Yeah. When you write about yourself, are you going to include this fear business that you're facing? And how that's going to affect your basic background of you have to help people? By the way, you never. By the way, you never do help people. I know the truth of the matter.
Yeah.
Like, are they made better as a result of what you help them with?
No.
No. So just.
They seem to become more handicapped.
Right. So you're doing the opposite of what you think you're doing. Wouldn't it be nice to get rid of that then?
Yeah, it would.
Yeah. Well, that's what you're facing.
Cool.
But right now you have a place, and now you're worried about where you have to go back and take care of.
Yeah.
The dog.
I'm thinking, okay, I'll go ahead and make my move and move into my new apartment, but I'll go back and visit.
No. Go back and do all the things that you have, that you're told to do.
Yeah, I was thinking I'd go back and cook meals and stuff like that.
Yeah, so you never left, except you sleep somewhere else.
Right?
Do you like that possibility? That's really not doing nothing, though.
That's true. That's true. Yeah. What a great opportunity.
Yeah, for doing nothing.
Yeah.
But you know, in doing nothing, you're going to end up doing something worthwhile for yourself.
Yeah.
Curious?
Yep.
Yeah.
Sounds like a vacation.
It does. And cheap.
You'll be so busy doing nothing, you won't have any time to do anything for anybody else.
That's right.
That's good. Is that good?
Yeah.
What do you think of that?
It's interesting.
Right.
It sounds like
He hit it, didn't he?
Oxymoron. Too busy doing nothing.
Are we really doing nothing when we're not doing anything, though? You know?
That's right. That's the question. It's a good Parmenidean question.
Mm-hmm. Are you getting into Parmenidean?
I like that stuff.
Really?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah.
I can't get into nothing.
Yeah, that'll do it to you.
That'll do it to you.
Why? Make you wonder between if doing nothing is the same as not doing anything.
Yeah, that's
right. Right, see, even he's got the bug. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Say, how do you like being a teacher?
Oh, man.
You are sharing what you're saying.
True.
Are you not?
Yeah, but that's going to make me cry.
Well, it's only because you're doing what you need, what you want to do. So you're not allowed to do that, are you?
Say that again?
It's what?
Say that again?
Yeah. Good morning.
Say that again, what you just said.
What?
Can you say that again, what you just said?
I forgot about it. What was it?
Something about because you're doing something you want to?
Yeah. What does it do to you when you're doing something you want to do? What you're going through now? Like you are sharing a lot, aren't you?
Well, I was until you brought it up.
And now you got to cut back.
Then I became aware of it.
Oh, and what's that like?
That's like really...
Uh-uh.
Feeling like I'm naked and being greedy and bad. And
see, being greedy and bad for doing what's good for yourself. Someone made you feel that way whenever you did something for yourself.
Right.
I wonder who they were.
Oh, yeah. The Christians.
Yeah, I know those people.
Those people.
Now you're out of it, though, right? Now you're okay. But now you slipped back into it just now, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, just now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Interesting, isn't it? You're into it now. Yeah.
Like, I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah, where does that go? Come on, quick, where does that go?
It's that rich aunt again.
Yeah.
You know, being at her house, it was like
something about that.
So,
That you need to look at.
Yeah.
What?
Well, in that dream that I explored here.
Yes, yes.
On October 28th. You know, there was that plastic plant holder that Gina's mathematical questions were in. And that guy from my school who was interested in the Logos, he had to grab that in order to be able to express himself in my dream. But then ultimately that pot, that plastic holder pot, I planted on my aunt's in the yard and on the soil in the raised bed by my aunt's driveway there. Mm-hmm. And it was a kind of an ideal setting because mm-hmm. she had a lovely garden. But as soon as I did that, then I immediately was in the driveway, walking around the car, looking to see where I had dented it, if I had dented it, and whether I was going to be charged with the crime, with the accident.
Mm-hmm.
So, which you said is like a counterattack.
No, forget what I said.
Okay.
Just go ahead.
So,
what do you think of those reflections that you did something on your own, planting?
Right.
Right? You're doing something that you wanted to do.
Right, cultivating what could grow and
yeah.
in an ideal
yeah.
soil.
Then you have to face all of these fears.
Right, of being guilty of creating
yeah.
some
yeah.
damage and
right.
accident. And
right. So therefore, hey,
mm-hmm.
you saw it there, but it must have had its origin from some earlier scene since you're just seeing it.
Oh, right.
It. Yeah.
Well, I know, like, when I was growing up, sometimes I'd, like, my mother didn't do much around the house. But every once in a while, I would get, like, this idea, like, okay, I'm going to rearrange the living room. I'm going to vacuum it and clean it. So I'd go to her and I'd say, Mother, I'm going to move a couple of things. Now, don't worry. Don't get upset.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I'd have to, like, warn her. Or I'd say, okay, I'm going to bake some chocolate chip cookies, but I just want you to know, don't worry. Don't get upset.
How old were you?
Like,
Eight, nine.
So I'd always have to, like, before I could do anything good, I'd always have to, like, warn her and set her mind at ease and
stuff. So you learn that.
Because I thought she'd freak out or something.
Yeah, but you learn that already in that scene. So
right.
looks like it's got to go earlier.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Earlier.
Yeah.
Boy, I don't know about earlier.
Don't just say anything. Hey, what do you remember at 3? Anything at all?
Well, the scene with being up at the lake
yeah.
in my aunt's lodge.
Mm-hmm.
And we were staying there because my father was up in Alaska. And I came in the building really excited to talk to my mother. And she was talking to the aunt, my father's sister. And they wouldn't look at me. My mother, I couldn't get her attention. And I kept saying, Mommy, Mommy. And then the aunt said, be quiet or we'll throw you out to the bears. And then she said, go sit on that couch. And don't say anything. Don't make any noise.
Yeah.
So there was that.
Yeah, but she saw you.
The aunt did.
Yeah.
Right, but not the mother. My mother didn't look
yeah.
at me.
But how did she look when she was saying those things?
She looked like she was really not connected with me emotionally. She wasn't seeing me. She was like in the midst of a... She was just kind of reacting to this, to me, the distraction. And just saying, get over there, distraction.
That's true.
And we, you know, saying mean things like, we'll throw you out to the bears.
Yeah. Yeah. You're not describing the state of mind she was in to put the fear of bears in your soul.
Right. Well, it seems like she was like in a panic or something. She was in a very heightened state of like emergency or panic or
urgent.
Something urgent, yeah.
Right.
Right.
Pointed.
Right.
Right. Clear. She's clear. She said what she...
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Powerful.
Right. And she also put it into words.
Yeah.
Like my mother... when I was 4... My father came back, or just before then, I guess. Like, if she got angry, she would get a stick off the tree and hit us. And she didn't put her anger into words so much. So I think I was impressed by the amount of words the aunt had used there.
Say it again?
I was impressed. By the amount of words
she used.
The aunt used.
Yeah.
Very graphic and...
Yeah, your mother never put it into words when she disciplined you.
No.
This one did.
Right.
Wow. That's a heck of a difference, isn't it?
Yeah. I knew exactly what to do. Go sit on that couch.
Otherwise...
Hold my hands and...
Yeah, there'd be
meat
for the bears.
Right.
Yeah, and your mother saw that you saw someone putting into words what she would never put into
true.
Words.
True. Yes, she did, yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah. And that kind of set the tone for us with that aunt. Like, she was always somebody to be afraid of, and we had to be on our best with our best manners at her house.
Yeah, go back to that scene for a moment.
Yeah.
Yeah. What was it like sitting there?
It was like I was just had my hands folded and I just was real quiet. And I was, it's kind of like sitting when I do meditation.
Yeah, is that similar? Hey, there's something similar.
Yeah.
Is it? You're back
that
there.
Is.
Yeah. But you're not allowed to do anything.
Right.
Can't go any, you can't say anything from that state. Gotta be silent.
Yeah.
Right? Even though you may have liked to have said something to her.
Yeah.
What?
Well, I mean, I might have liked to listen to the conversation and see if I could.
But that closed it down.
Because they were probably talking about my father and our whole living situation.
Yeah.
Maybe I could have even offered some input.
Yeah. Couldn't go any further. That was the limit.
Right.
Right. Is that equally like that sitting? Reach a certain limit and can't go beyond it?
Well, Well, actually what happens with my sitting is that it starts getting really like practical, you know, like I start thinking about like writing I'm doing and how it could be improved, or I start getting insights into stuff I'm doing in my daily life, and I start thinking of things, oh yeah, I forgot about doing that, I need to do that, and so
And what do you do with it? See, what do you do with it now that you got such rich material?
I carry it out. I do it.
You actually write it out.
Yeah.
That's what you're doing now. you're actually writing the material that comes up when you're sitting about things you had forgotten.
No, I don't write it out when I'm sitting.
I mean after.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I'm not sitting right now.
Yeah.
Sorry, you write it out or you do it?
Well, whatever. If it's a writing thing, then I would write it.
Okay.
Or if it's a doing thing. So it's helpful, but it's very practical.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Too bad. Too bad.
Yeah.
Why? You gave up nothing.
I gave up nothing. I should have given up something.
Oh, the question is, you're in a different state?
Oh, I gave up the nothing.
You
right, yeah,
nothing.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, to be practical.
Yeah, it becomes like just
yeah.
Creating a shopping list. Or
yeah. What do you think of that? See, you,
right.
Yeah. In our discussion, see, we were on one level and then
uh-huh.
you dropped into the practical side and introduced that. Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah. We got that. Yeah. Yeah. Go back to where you were before. We were wondering whether or not there's some relationship between your sitting and what you learned with your ass.
Yeah.
And you said, by God, the sitting is something like sitting.
Yeah.
Right, with my aunt. Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And therefore we're wondering whether that the limit you experienced with her at that time is
uh-huh.
similar to what you're doing with your sitting.
Right.
Right. Can't go any further. Right. Afraid maybe you're gonna face something.
Okay. Well, yeah, the thing with the aunt was like shut down.
Yeah.
And I couldn't think about anything.
Yeah. Hmm. How many similarities do you find between these two events then? The sitting and the fear that you can't go any further, and the sitting with your grandmother, I mean your aunt,
uh-huh.
and you can't go any further. It looks very similar, doesn't it? What do you make of that?
Yeah.
You fear in the one case you may die, and you fear in the other case you may die. Maybe thrown to the bears.
Yeah, I guess there's a kind of a can't relax state with the aunt. And, but when I sit for myself, I don't know. I mean, it does get practical sometimes.
Yeah, if you go back to the question.
Uh-huh.
Right, you slipped out of it. What's it like dealing with this question? Is it possible that the similarities you are experiencing sitting are similar to the experiences you had with your aunt that time? In both cases, you end up in a certain kind of nothingness and a fear of going further. Right, there's a fear of death, there's a fear
yeah.
of death.
Yeah, yeah.
It looks mm-hmm. like there's some similarities, aren't there?
That does happen. I do get into that state sometimes.
Yeah.
I'm sitting.
Yeah. Are you agreeing that there looks like there are such similarities?
Well, there are sometimes, and that's when I will often quit sitting.
Yeah.
When I reach that point.
Yeah.
Because it's like something's not allowing me to relax into the sitting.
Yeah.
And it's like I'm just. It's awful in that state. I can't relax. And I'm, yeah.
Because, finish it because.
I don't know why that time.
Of course you don't know why. That's why we're expecting that. I'm wondering whether there's any similarity, whether that could be a model.
Usually I render a judgment. I'll say, well, I can't relax into my sitting right now because I'm just not there right now. You know, I declare this condition that I have right now that, sorry, you just can't do it right now because you're not.
Yeah, yeah.
Like I'm waiting for, you know how people will wait for some feeling to come about before they do stuff. It's like I'm waiting for that.
Yeah.
Like, I'm just not in that feeling or that condition right now.
Yeah, yeah.
So I better just quit because this is going nowhere.
That's right. But on the other hand, if it goes nowhere, you're in a pretty good state. You'd be taking it negatively.
Right.
That now I should look for some feeling to urge me to do something.
Yeah, what a better place to do nothing than nowhere.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, just say it again.
What a better place to do nothing than nowhere.
And on the other hand, is there any better place to be than at that point doing nothing nowhere?
No.
Yeah.
I'm right where I should be. So
that's right.
Don't get up at that point.
Yeah, why get up at that
oh,
point?
Oh, boy. All these years, okay.
Yeah.
Shoot. Okay. Yeah.
Can I ask a question about the beautiful garden? Did you ever get the chance to go out into the beautiful garden?
Yeah, whenever I could.
And what was her response to that? Or was there any issues regarding doing that?
Well, yeah, I always, because the family would be sitting in the big living room, right? Just sitting there. And it was always so uncomfortable. So I would go outside where the dog was. She had beautiful dogs, or a beautiful dog. And these beautiful grounds with all these flowers. And I always felt like a little guilty, like I should be in, it was kind of like being at church. I felt like I should be in that living room with all the uncomfortable people saying uncomfortable things. It was awful. So I felt a little guilty being out there.
How come you felt that you wanted to be? That would be interesting to find out why you ended up feeling guilty in such a beautiful arena, area. And is there anything similar to that even in your sitting?
Well, you know, it was one of the rare times when my parents, for example, were sitting together in the same room.
Sure.
And I felt like I should...
Say, what's it like talking this way and the way we were talking a moment ago?
Well, it's speculative.
Huh?
It's speculative at this point.
What?
She's asking me. No, it's not.
That's where you're in that interesting state of trying to figure out nothingness.
Right.
Right?
Yeah. She tried to make something of it.
Yeah.
That's a luck.
So, what are you going to do with your sitting? And that state of mind. What are you going to do?
Cultivate it.
And face that fear.
Yeah.
Can we expect if you play that, you might even end up being even a better teacher than you are right now?
Yeah.
Ooh. Then your friend Barbara should encourage you to get there and break through.
Yeah.
Right. Go fight Win Yen. Well, that's football. What can I tell you?
Bumper sticker.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can I ask something, though? Wait. Here's a dream.
Oh, great.
But I wanted to ask Pierre and Julie something, which is we've done some writing on our goals last couple of days, and Julie is transcribing her last dream session. All this you probably know.
Mm-hmm.
And you uncovered the idea that you had to hide. Do you remember that? Like, and the reason I'm bringing this up is, you might recall what I'm talking about? Hide yourself. The instance was specifically tied to Pierre asking you many times, what was your experience of meditation in Korea? And you said, oh, you never talked about that. and you know the and the reason
yeah,
why.
That's right.
Okay, so how did you describe it?
Hmm.
Or you used the word.
Well, okay, yeah. I mean, I don't. Yeah, I'm reluctant to talk about it.
Yeah, but it wasn't only that. But to share, it was well. To share, you yourself. Right. There was.
Yeah.
You wanted to keep it hidden.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
That's bringing you into an interesting state. And the reason I'm bringing this up is because you got in a very interesting contemplative state yesterday, the last day we were writing, and you were like, man, you were in this state where you looked like you were watching the bright shining paradigm going, okay? and I asked...
That's you watching
the paradigm. And so I wondered whether... I mean, you'd go into... intently watching, and then you might type like 7 words, and then you go back watching. And so I wondered, and I asked you, and as Pierre had suggested, whether you're trying to capture your insights as you have them when you're transcribing the dream review.
Oh, well, as I told you before, I don't write them down because I'm assuming after I get this all typed up, I'll go back and read it again. And I
come
know
to
those
the
places
same.
That are going to be, that were shocking when I typed them up.
Hmm.
I'm assuming I'll still see
them. Not just thing. Shocking, but positively insightful?
Yeah, yeah.
But so, have you done any of that to see if that's the case?
No, I haven't quite finished. I have a few more minutes left of the tape. I'll print it out.
Okay.
So,
well, then you'll have a test case. Well,
yeah.
I had just okay. So we can't
but,
really go
I
back
mean,
there.
I mean, it's possible, you know, that I should make a note when I'm transcribing. I should make a note at the moment that I see that point, because when I have gone over it a little bit, seems like the impact of that insight is not so strong. Watered down now. So you're right. I
and
should,
maybe the
I should
precise
make a note
language.
Like the, yeah, and the feeling and the images and stuff.
So it's
but
an
if
insight
you were to
while
do that,
you're transcribing something comes up.
Yeah.
But if you
really.
Were to do that, what would that in effect be saying? Or did I?
Well, it would in effect be saying that I'm seeing something.
Mm-hmm. And how valuable would you be saying that seeing is?
Very valuable.
I mean, very valuable.
Because sometimes when I'm in the talk, you know, things are happening so quickly, I might focus on one thing and then a couple other things don't get so much focus.
Mm-hmm.
But when I'm transcribing it, that might be seen again and really hit me as important. So, yeah. I'll make notes now when I transcribe. Thank you. Do you want to sit here, Bill? Will he sit
yeah, next to Pierre on one side or the other.
Okay, Bill, why don't you sit here?
Julie, why don't you stay where you are? Oh,
okay. Is there another copy?
Oh, yeah. I brought 10 copies.
Oh, also, you changed it to this chair. Cool.
That's
good. What? Thank you. I was thinking of making one here at Grimes Academy with a picture of us, like at the seminar or something. Wouldn't that be fun?
Is this place the
Academy of the Self? Not the place, but the painting. It's in the Vatican.
I was thinking it would be cool if we went to the place to took that picture.
Oh, fun. I agree, absolutely.
Did you do it, or...?
Zazzle.
Oh, sorry.
We'll do it. Basically, we'll do it. The company on the internet, www.zazzle.com, whatever. They'll do it basically with anything.
Oh.
And this somebody had already set this up.
It's got. No, it's fine.
Yeah.
I thought you were walking.
Did you know?
I think it has. Is it hot dogs or some different things in there?
You know these?
Because he's a bit vegetarian.
Kolaches. Yeah.
What's in it?
Okay. This one is tomato, egg, and potato. That's vegetarian.
Oh, cool.
Oh.
And these are fruit ones.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
So they don't have as much protein in them.
I don't know if there's enough copies. I brought 10 copies. And should be somewhere.
Which,
else.
Which everybody's got a copy.
Which country is this from?
Czechoslovakia.
Interesting.
But there's a whole bunch of people in Texas now. Actually, this was the original kolache, but then these Czech people moved to Texas, and they made them savory. So now they've got all kinds.
So kolache means cake in Bosnian.
Okay.
Do you want me to read it out loud?
Yeah.
Please. Okay.
A group of people gather. I can't figure what they're doing. I did know when I was waiting for it. They all gave speeches, and now I can't remember what it was. I had something in mind to say, and somebody said, "Is there a William Gilbert here?" And I said, "I've never been here before. It's the first time I came here, and I don't know what to say about it. I know I'll come back again." That was the thought. I don't know what to say, but before they called on me, I was so surprised that I forgot what I was going to say, which is quite interesting. I usually have something to say, and it's interesting that I forgot what I was going to say when I came up, because I know I had something to say. Interesting, I'm kind of repeating. Mm-hmm. I think it's amazing that I forgot what I was going to say. The state of mind is that I was astounded that I didn't have something to say. I don't remember if I said it out loud or awake, or if I said it when I was asleep, but I said it loud and clear. And I keep repeating this. I forgot to say what I was going to say. And it's an interesting dream. Why I was given that dream, I forgot that I was going to say. I keep saying that. I had something very clear to say, and it was such a surprise when he asked me, is William Gilbert here? And it just astounded me. And it became very quiet after that, which was very significant to me. Nobody said anything at all, and then I woke up. And that was... I didn't trust that I really captured the dream, so I immediately turned it on and recorded it again. And I don't think I said anything more in the second version, except I gave more of the context for it, and which is not here, but there had been a meeting of people doing something, like a dance group or something along that line, where everybody did this thing, and then they came to a restaurant to meet and reflect on what had happened. And I forgot what that was about as well. So I couldn't say that either. I had this kind of a memory problem. So it was like I had this in mind, what I was going to say, and then as soon as he said William Gilbert here, it struck me, because nobody calls me William Gilbert. Just, you know, very kind of boom, it was gone.
So you didn't read the other one?
I didn't read the second one, no. Think I should?
Just here?
I don't think I said anything in there except the description of the tables. What bothered me when I started to read the second one is to say that I don't usually have something to say. It's that I really did have something to say about the situation, and that I was going to say it, and it all just went away when he said William Gilbert. It was just boom. And it wasn't true that I didn't have anything to say. I had something to say. It was gone.
Good. So, what would you do with it? Where would you go? What would you look at?
It sounded like when somebody said your full name, William Gilbert, that threw you off and made you lose your what you were going to say.
Okay.
Is that something?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm looking at the state that Salem was talking about.
I didn't.
Rhonda?
Not yet.
Me, not yet.
I guess I would wonder about that state when he says he was astounded that he didn't have something to say.
Mm-hmm. What would you want to know?
What that was like.
Go ahead.
What was that like?
Well, I was, two things. I was disturbed that what I had planned, people were saying why they were there, what their experience was of this meeting. So I had prepared something in my mind, why I was there, who I was, that's what was going on, you know, that people were giving kind of a brief, and I was prepared with something like that, and then when he said that, it was disturbing to me that I didn't have that anymore. It was, you know, and I think I, in reflecting on it, it was like, almost like I was not telling them the truth. I should have said, I just had something to say, but I forgot it. That would be a more honest answer. So I wasn't being fully honest with them. I wasn't saying what it truly was going on.
Does that answer your question?
No.
What was it like? I was lost. Or
what?
Kind of a lost for what to say. I mean, it was even about what my present situation. When I said I don't know what to say, I would say I forgot what they were going to say. That would be a better way to answer it. It's not being truthful.
Does that answer it?
Did I answer your question?
It does. It's such a rich state, but it's unpacked even more now. So
did it answer it or not?
No.
What? Mm-mm. What? How do you? How will you ask it so you can get the kind of answer you think is important? Okay. Hey, Bill. It's likely you've been astonished before about many things in life.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. If you were to rank this experience among all those other states you were astonished, where would you put this one in the dream?
Well, to call it being astonished, be more like troubled than astonished.
I'll take both. Same thing. Astonished, troubled. Good.
It's pretty high.
It's pretty high stage.
Yeah.
Yeah, could you put words on it?
In one sense, it's perplexing. It's I'm having difficulty even saying now what it was. It's very, very... to have, because there was, as they were answering their, you know, people standing up saying why they were there and so forth, it was, because we just had a rich meeting, and it was like something happened. I couldn't even remember what we'd just done.
Okay.
You know, the group. It was that.
You said protecting a moment ago.
Protecting?
Did you?
No, I don't remember.
Oh, what word did you use before?
That, I don't know, protecting.
Well, lost what to say. What is that kind of astonishing?
well, I wasn't saying really what I was, where I was at to them. I wasn't
That's
saying,
true.
I had something to say, but I forgot it. Would be the best thing, the most truthful thing to say. I was almost going to say it, but I didn't.
Disturbing.
Disturbing would be a good word.
That was the word you used last time.
Disturbing, yeah. Every time I try to recall this, I say something different. It's that it astounded me that I didn't, you know, that I'd lost it. You know, it was like,
so look,
it's unusual.
See, what we're trying to uncover is what kind of state of mind that is in.
Yeah, I'm trying to uncover it, too.
Like, would you say it's boring?
No.
Well, let me try again.
No.
Dull?
No. There's a wonder to it.
It's a wonder to it.
There's a wonder there.
Yeah, more.
It's empty.
What?
There's a kind of emptiness
to
it.
Yeah, kind of empty. Go ahead.
But it's still...
Part of what you're doing is dealing with the consequences of that state.
I got you.
But I don't want to deal with that. I just want to stay in that state of mind.
And I didn't want to stay in that state of mind in a way, you know, but still.
Pierre.
What was that?
Well, I didn't want to stay in that state of mind. I wanted to have something to say.
Yeah.
I want to hear
more about that state.
It's a very rich experience that we'd all gone through, you know. And they were offering something great. The problem was...
I don't care about that stuff.
It was me recognizing that was me, he's saying.
Ah, forget that. Go back to the state of mind.
It was empty.
Yeah, yeah. By the way, have you ever done an A sitting?
Yeah. Yeah.
Go ahead.
There are no thoughts if it's the best.
Oh, it's just, are you saying it's similar?
Yeah, but I've never judged the thing negative.
What kind of a state were you in then?
Oh, boy.
Come on. In the dream, similar to that Zen stuff?
I wouldn't have judged it that way if I was sitting and it were gone like that. See, because then I, in this situation, I would be impressing them in a way.
My thoughts would be to
impress them that I have these certain qualifications. And
put that aside. If you had spoken out of that state, what would have happened?
You mean the state that I, after the stuff went away, or before that?
Empty.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't speak out of that state.
What?
I wouldn't speak out of that empty state.
Yeah, I know, that's why we're talking about it.
Yeah, I know. But before the empty state, I would have been an ego state. Yes. In fact, it would have been very close. Yeah, no, I wouldn't speak out of that state.
Why not?
Because there's nothing there.
Why not?
It's empty.
But that's why you can talk.
I mean, that's why I can talk.
Yeah. Then you don't have to do what you planned. You don't have to, right? You don't have to deal with what's expected or what you think would impress people. It's all gone.
That's right. I said, I don't know what to say, but I know I'll be back.
But what?
I know I'll be back.
Yeah.
I know it's good, and I'll be back.
Yeah, I know it's good. I'll be back.
Right. That's what it said.
Yeah, because you were in a good state.
Yeah, it was good. I couldn't deny it was good. Everybody there was good. Everything was positive.
But you were in a state out of which, if you did talk,
it would be as, I don't know, you couldn't capture what had happened there with a simple statement. I never thought of it this way.
That it would be nothing that you planned?
That's right.
Right. Did have a clean script?
Because I was planning what I was going to say.
But all
while
of that
these people
is out.
Were talking, and when he said my name, it became empty.
Yeah.
It's gone.
Now you have a gift.
It's gone.
Now you have a gift. What are you going to do with it?
I don't know what you're saying when you ask that. Good.
Yeah, but that's it. You don't know. That's right.
It's been very perplexing.
Right.
See, like when I made the second recording, I said I usually have something to say. That troubled me.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I didn't like that at all.
Yeah, because that's revealing.
That reveals that I'm a bullshitter.
Yeah, right.
Because, I usually fill this hole up with something.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
There was very definite, something definite there, and it was gone because of this very rich
thing. Even though it was definite, you think you might have gone beyond it?
Oh, it was limited.
It was limited.
It would be limited.
Or unlimited.
Well, it's unlimited if I don't say anything. If I'm... The only thing you can say is it's good. That would capture it.
Yeah.
To say anything more about me or my qualifications or to say something specific about it was limited.
Yeah.
Except for the fact that it was good and I'll be back.
Yeah, sure.
That captured it.
Yeah.
nothing else would capture it.
Yeah.
And not even to, because I couldn't come up with specifics about what we had done.
Yeah, isn't that wonderful?
Yeah, it is.
So is William Gilbert here?
It wasn't even, you know, nobody calls me William Gilbert. That's the part of, oh, that's me.
Now, what are you doing here, Bill, to coming up with these enlightenment station you're training?
I don't know. I like it. You're puzzling over since it happened. You know, even the second version doesn't quite, you know, just, it lost it.
Yeah.
I came up with specifics about the place and
whether
the guy came up with
that's
it.
That's old stuff.
I came up with the strip, described the tables and,
you
know, just, what do you got?
Here, I wanted to ask a question. You don't want to investigate why the name William Gilbert threw him off, threw him in that state? You don't want to ask that question, or?
No, you did.
I did?
Yes, and I thought that was an interesting question.
Okay, because I'm
just... You're interested in knowing what? Did you have a good question, by the way, but how would you push it?
I would say, like, does that... Somebody calling you by your full name.
No. Stay with the words for a moment.
Okay.
Ask it again.
So when somebody said William Gilbert, it threw you into that state.
No, you left out the key part. Do it again.
Who?
No. Read it.
Oh. He was such a surprise when he asked me. When he said, is William Gilbert here?
Say it again.
It was such a surprise when he asked me, when he said, is William Gilbert here?
Yeah. What do you think of the word here?
Oh.
What are you laughing at? Come on. What are you saying?
Are we talking... I don't know.
Come on, try it.
Are we trying to figure out who is the real William Gilbert, or?
You're leaving out the question. Is he here?
You mean like, was he fantasizing somewhere else, or what? I don't know what that means.
He answered it.
He did?
That's where he is. That state of mind. See, how important is the word here in that statement, see? Is this an anagogic dream? See, a profound dream? Like, hey, is Bill Gilbert here?
What would you say now? When you read it, I say there is nobody here.
That's right.
It's
empty.
When you say, is William Gilbert here, that's...
Oh.
There's no one.
Yeah,
it's totally empty.
That's why you were stuck and lost.
it's a dodge to say that the full name put me off. If you just said, "Is Bill Gilbert here?" It wouldn't have been any different. It's here.
Yeah, I
the
see
more you read it, the more it helps.
Okay,
thank you. I mean, it does. Yeah. The here part is the, you know, there's no one. And I tried to dodge out of it with my second version here.
Yeah.
You know, I tried to say, well, it's a problem because I said usually. The point is that it's empty.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Good?
Yes, thank you.
So, Bill,
yeah?
I do have to take back my rather slurry remark in the beginning.
Which is?
Well, the one about if you wake up, you'll be angry. It doesn't appear to be the case. You don't remember my saying that?
No.
Good!
Now, the real thing that was very interesting was that I woke up saying this out loud, and it was like so silent. And I couldn't tell whether it was in the dream or being awake, and whether there were people not listening to me, or they were there, or it was just incredibly empty. Incredibly empty.
Lovely.
Pretty nice,
That was totally.
You're getting into some pretty interesting stuff.
Very interesting. Very interesting.
Yeah.
Very interesting.
Yeah.
And I didn't know whether I was awake or asleep or.
Wait a minute. You didn't need to.
No.
Right.
Didn't disturb me at all.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. What do you think of that?
And when I left it out of this recording here, but I was laughing all the time in this recording.
Right. How does that fit with what you were talking about a few minutes ago?
Sounds like he went the next step. He kept sitting.
Yeah.
He disappeared.
Yeah. He didn't die.
And he didn't. He came back to life.
That's nice of him that he didn't die. Yeah.
Thank you for that report.
Yeah. Rhonda's probably thankful too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes. I like him. He was laughing the whole time he was recording it.
Did you hear Bill added something?
What?
I don't think Pierre or heard it.
Well, when I recorded the second one, I was laughing.
He said he was laughing the whole time he was recording.
And there I'm writing chuckle, chuckle, chuckle. What I'm
in a good state.
Oh, yeah. No,
yeah, no. In that state.
Well, when I, yeah. The recording shows up. Yeah.
Wow.
And I didn't know if I was awake or asleep. That's the thing. Rhonda said she kind of heard me say something, but it was like, it was so clearly said. Did I say that asleep or awake? You know, it's like, even that didn't bother me. Just it's so silent.
Wow.
It's just so empty.
What? Therefore? Similar.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Curious. You live near the guy?
So is that a shikantaza?
Something like that.
Emptiness?
Yeah, shikantaza. Living in emptiness.
Yeah. Is that, the more you talk about it, thank you very much, Theon. It's like, it's William Gilbert here. It's like, it took a while to think.
Oh, here?
No, I'm not here.
Is somebody else here?
Right, yeah.
Because whatever had been done was very, very positive. I mean, the group, you know.
And it's okay to be here, to not be here, it sounds like.
Yeah, or, yeah, it's, you know.
You want to hear my notes?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, right.
did I miss it, or did we explore his answer?
Sir?
Did we explore his answer?
What did you say?
Did we explore my answer?
What did you say?
Said, did we explore my answer to their question, to their response?
Did the exploration explore Bill's answer to the question?
Huh?
What did you say?
Yeah. He thought maybe he missed it, but I don't think he missed it. Maybe
that's
he doesn't
what
know
thought.
What an answer would be.
Yeah. So you ask him. I'll sit back and listen.
Yes.
It's in the dream.
It's in the dream?
It's right there intact.
I've never been here before.
You did have an answer.
It's the first time I came here, and I don't know what to say about it. I know I'll come back again.
That's not what you're referring to.
That is what I'm referring to.
Yeah, I don't know what to say about it.
But you did say it.
I don't know what to say about it.
Oh.
It's empty.
Hmm.
Yeah, the whole time you're saying you don't have an answer, but you did.
But I've never been here before.
The before is interesting, isn't it?
Well, yeah, I'm not sure what you see in that.
I'm not sure what I see either. Why do you
think... If it's empty, I've never been here before is to say that I don't have it's no content. But you have a good question. I've never been here before. It's the first time it's like I didn't have... It is the first time I was there. I mean, in the sense that I couldn't answer it. It disappeared. Everything disappeared. It was,
so
I knew
cool.
It was good. It was good.
So cool.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You have a good question.
Yeah. See, and to talk out of that state would have been quite interesting.
Yeah. Mm.
Yeah. No.
Mm. No criticism.
No.
No. No. Drawing upon what previously was canned, or
no, I knew I'd never been there before. I mean, in the sense that something fresh and alive, but it was good.
So what?
And the people were good, and you know, and it was
ideal set.
Does that take you back though to Pierre's original question about How does this compare to the states of mind that are similar you might have experienced while sitting or in some other?
Oh, yeah.
How does it compare?
Like doing Mu, something like that. Very,
okay, but
very familiar, but very empty and very familiar in a way, you know, but still.
High or lower?
High, very high. Yeah, very high. Yeah.
High, yes?
Possibly playing flute.
Close to the highest?
Yeah. Hmm? Among the highest. Yeah.
Among the highest.
Can't say among because it doesn't work for you.
Because what?
That doesn't fit very well either.
The among doesn't fit
very well.
Right.
Like Therefore, Julie was saying, when you know you're finished, right? Many times I've played the flute and looked and figured, well, that's 45 minutes, that's enough. But sometimes, you know, I say, well, that's my embouchure's gone, I can't play anymore. And sometimes I'm playing and I look at the time, God, I've been playing for an hour and a half, I never thought I'd play that long. I still have a good lip, I mean, what the hell's going on, you know? Mm-hmm. And I've just been playing and playing. You know?
Fun?
One step.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Playful.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, you want to share?
Wow.
I knew I had to explore it. Yeah, I'm sure.
Yeah. Here, do you have plans for Jeff's dream? He had a dream
sure.
last night. But,
oh,
so there,
man.
Now you're stuck.
Do you have copies of that?
Good for you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, coffee break.
Do you
want to
sit in my
seat?
Yeah, I'll get the camera. I had a really fun dream before I woke up.
Oh, another one.
Yeah.
You can. You can get this from the plan. Yeah, there was a lot of pissy people last night, huh, Barbara?
I was pissy last night.
There was a couple.
Really?
I consider it here.
What?
Really? We've been watching this for a while.
Anybody else?
State of mind on ripping the dream in.
That was a very interesting state of mind. I was watching that myself.
Even though basketball skills are not his strength.
Yeah,
Well, what do you make of the dream?
Well, lots of things come to mind. First of all, there's a lot of the typical in my head stuff, but I'm not doing much in the way of speaking or acting.
Yeah. What does that do in the dream to you?
Like, what price do I pay for that? It cuts me off from others.
Yeah. And, in the last five, though, you are entertaining some ideas, are you not?
You mean the puzzle at the end?
Yeah.
That I'm in as I do that is that is actually, if there's anywhere in the dream that I really, like I'm holding that up as others watch, like I'm showing it to everybody. Yeah. Minimally relational.
Yeah, but you are voicing, are you not? Or is that only a thought?
No.
Two questions.
It's only a thought. I don't voice it. I don't say it.
Pardon?
I'm only thinking, I don't say it to anyone.
So then, it goes back to that same theme you picked up earlier, right, that you're not saying anything.
Sure.
That limits and cuts you off.
And what's interesting is, after our reflection on my dream the other day, about me taking on other people's issues and problems, and then not only that, but the injustices sometimes that come with those.
Mm-hmm.
Ultimately, not going for the things I want to do for myself.
Yeah.
I don't see much of that in here.
Yeah.
It's the same thing going on. So not only am I cut off from others, but I don't see anything in the screen that says, hey, I want to toss a basketball. I only see what other people want to do. Until the end here, I have this question about the beans, but it's...
Stay in the first paragraph.
Yeah.
Yeah. What do you see in the first paragraph? Just read it, okay? Read it out loud.
Get me in the spirit.
Yeah. Could you read it out loud?
Kira and I are walking over to my old house. This is a house, by the way, where my mother lived, but my father never lived. We are going through the backyards in the neighborhood. He has a basketball with him and is tossing it around playfully, I think to get me in the spirit, even though basketball skills are not his strength.
At that moment, you have to make a decision, don't you?
It's like I'm asleep, though.
Well, say when you're watching this guy tossing the ball around playfully, what do you see?
He's a little uncoordinated, but...
And therefore, what do you think of your...
I'm going along with it because it's special or rare.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a lot of this in this dream that reflects my father.
Yeah, because... does it show any interest
in me
playing or basketball or
in myself
in the dream?
Yeah, that's the crux of the issue, isn't it? As usual, the Grimes laser.
Well,
and that leads directly to a question about a state of mind. I mean, that's
yeah,
right.
Yeah,
what is that state of mind?
Right there. Like if you did have an interest in playing, what do you think of the colleague you are going to be playing with? Did you say a moment ago, not very coordinated?
Right.
Yeah.
So it would not be a high level of...
Yeah.
If there were competition involved, it wouldn't be a high level of it.
Yeah.
But I've always had a problem with competition anyway.
Yep, no.
I much prefer just tossing the ball around.
But you see, that's why we want to know what was in the dream at that moment.
Well, give me a second, because I am trying to focus on that.
Yeah.
I know exactly the point.
Mm-hmm. You're watching him tossing the ball around.
You know, and there are these two moments in the dream, or maybe three, where I'm aware of light. And that's one of them. There's light around that scene.
Mm-hmm.
Like he's in a really good state, that uncoordinated Pierre guy.
Yeah.
So much so that it obfuscates the question of whether I am really interested. So clearly a pathologos transmission, I guess. Possibility anyway.
You mentioned something about light.
Yeah.
Yeah, talk about it.
Well, in that, right then at that moment, at the beginning, it's not just the sunlight, it's that there's a beatific, like an aura, around you and around us. That's representing that state of mind, actually. It's part and parcel of the state of mind. That you are in, probably trying to get me into, in that scene. But there's another one that has light, which is the point down in 4, and you're throwing me the ball directly. And yeah. You're under the trees, but there's still an aura of light around you. So those are the two really high points.
Say, I guess you go along with that theory that if you are with someone in that state, it's best to play basketball.
Well, that's the same question, right?
Yeah. especially when
I want to, you know, what comes to mind is, is Bill's question.
Yeah, what?
You know, is William Gilbert here, or is Jeff Stern here? Like, who's here? Like, what's... Like, you'd have to split off. Self would have to split off and go do whatever makes it happy and creative and joyful and spontaneous and curious.
What does that do for
you? I'd have to pull out of that.
Yeah, go ahead.
Light out of that.
I'd have to
pull out of that light. I'd have to have a sense of self to pull out of that light.
Maybe there's one there.
No, that's right. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But I'd have to have a sense of it.
Yes, I'd have to have a sense of it.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Do you? Go ahead.
But of course.
Go ahead, say that.
Of course not. All at the same time.
You want to say, repeat that in another way?
All the old structures are falling.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. What was the question we're working on, by the way?
Well, one of those structures.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Do you have an idea of the soul?
The reason I say yes and no is let me put it no and yes. Mm-hmm. Because I don't have an idea of the self. More and more, less and less do I have any. I'm working on getting rid of ideas of the self. Mm-hmm. Any images. Mm-hmm. And yet the more that I do that, and I walk around with Xenophanes in my head, I have less and less an idea of the self, and yet more and more evidence of it.
That's right. I'll put that in this ring.
That's the last two sentences.
Mm-hmm. I'll try answering them.
About no bag at all, or something like that.
the thing you're missing in the dream, you now have to put in.
Oh, that's what you mean by put it in.
All set?
Um, I want to ride my bike.
What state of mind were you in this dream?
Back to that.
Yep.
Follower. Follower.
More.
Acquiesce. Make them happy. Be the good kid.
Yeah, that's right. Now, see, there's a crisis here in the dream. Right? Are you a follower? If you are a follower, see, the word follower could be in two senses.
How so?
Well, is this guy, Pierre, is he in any sense in a state of mind that likes to be a follower of?
Yes.
Now the other sense says the follower of? Playing with incompetent people so they can be happy.
Right, Hugh.
So I want to know what state of mind you were in the dream. Because it's missing.
Well, for me it's pretty clear at that point, at least in, if you're talking about the first paragraph.
Yeah.
That I'm in the second.
Yeah, right.
I'm just following.
Yeah.
In that lower sense.
Yeah. So what would it take in the dream for you to dump that?
In the dream?
Yeah.
Make my own light.
Yeah. That's all you have to give up.
Nice.
Thanks as always.
Good dream. Very good dream. Mm. Thank you.
You said I get some free care doodles with it?
Yeah, yeah, right. Those are great work.
Would you like me to take a picture of them and send them to you?
You're so funny. Thank you.
And now people can call upon you for help in understanding whatever difficulties they have in meditation. Agree?
Mm. Yes,
and
they
breathing
can.
And all these other things. Mm. Right? Good. Congratulations, teach.
Pierre, is it just my imagination?
I don't know. Let me see.
Why am I even asking you? Or is there a whole lot of growth going on in this group in the last year or maybe two that I did not witness the 10 years before that? Like, it's not that people were, well, I was probably asleep the last 10 years. But it seems like there's an acceleration. Mm. People are really hitting new highs and new insights, and it's showing itself in terms of their waking life, how they're actually functioning.
Yeah, yeah.
And a level of bravery and courage in many
it's
of us.
Increasing.
It's pretty awesome.
Pretty awesome. Yeah.
What's
coffee?
Coffee.
Those beans.
You cut me off at the pass.
Coffee.
Well,
go ahead.
I wonder if it has to do with, you remember there was a point at which in the last, and I'm never good with years, but I'd say it's in within the last three or four years, that you decided to really show your own philosophy, right? Mm-hmm. What you could most call most uniquely your own. And out of that came some of the material on self. And
yeah.
So I wonder if that didn't contribute to an maybe it's just critical mass of some sort. Mm. But
I don't know that that's true. I just wonder, because that is the case.
And as you say that, we're probably just a corollary point, but it reminds me of your talk with Jed the other, last Friday, not last night, but previous, where we were talking about going back to the parent or a surrogate and having those questions, and you were emphasizing that how, regardless of any other also positive benefits, the primary focus is the self.
Yes. That's right.
And it seems like what Barbara is saying is you've been doing that in the last...
I have a practical question. Are we meeting tomorrow for Parmenides? Or are you in Arizona? Arizona.
Is that Plato?
Yeah.
Arizona. That's funny.
Yes.
Okay. Panera, until we find a better place?
Yeah. Nancy this morning was thinking, is it possible that we can get in touch with these centers around town? Like, there's the Costa Mesa Community Centers, there's some in Huntington Beach, maybe even Seal Beach.
To use for the meeting?
The Senior Center.
Senior Fund Center.
The Senior Center in Costa Mesa has meeting places.
For the morning, you're talking about from the 7 to 9 a.m.?
Yeah.
There's a Huntington Beach Senior Center. I don't know what time they open up, but that's right on Golden West.
What's the public suggestion?
It's a nice place. I've been in there. I don't know what time they open up.
Well, actually, Pierre said that the group is getting too big for Panera.
Yeah.
I don't think either of the other things were playing a role at this point.
That Christian group's got like 15 guys in it. They don't seem to care.
Yeah, but
the Christian group is huge.
Yeah, but they're too loud.
Is that what they are?
We don't have to leave the table there. We've moved the table.
I'll find out from Huntington Beach.
Okay.
Would you
want to
check
that out?
Well, I mean, there's like Norm's restaurant is open 24 hours.
But that's crazy.
And on behalf of the listeners...
At 7 in the morning?
Well, I don't know about 7.
What do you got?
24. And on behalf of the listeners remotely, and also Barbara and myself try to record the war that we're having with the Panera management over these speakers in the city.
Yeah, that's a pain in the neck.
It is really getting tiring.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the Christmas music is loud.
Christmas music, and
so are you going to...
I'll check Huntington Beach.
And?
I'll check Costa Mesa. But Costa Mesa tends to be...
And there's another one now on Golden West College.
Golden West.
Senior Center as well, a new one.
On Golden West College? Mm. Okay, I'll check that.
Yeah, it's by somewhere near the lake.
That's the Golden... That's a senior center.
Yeah.
That's, I don't know what time they open up, but I'll find out.
Yeah. So it's kind of creative. Just keep it on your mind. Is that try anything and let's see if we can find a place.
If you're in a pinch, I could offer my place for a while.
Pardon?
If you get in a pinch and you just have to throw up your hands and leave Panera, I could. In the meantime, I could offer my place again.
Well,
for 7 in the morning.
What about it?
Well, I'm here.
I'm okay with that.
Apparently,
Dave's place is charming. Although he works his ass off.
Well,
to get
while
it
we con- while we consciously look for another. Another place.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, David.
Okay. So if you want to meet here tomorrow, that's fine.
Yeah.
And Sundays are usually
and
8, right?
At 8.
If we do that, then I like your idea of getting coffee at one of these places and bringing it rather than put the load on David.
Making coffee is not the load. The snacks will not be an issue. I will not be providing snacks.
Okay.
Well, I can always stop and get snacks.
Oh, there we have it.
But that would, you know, if you... I would appreciate that because cleaning up and, you know, basically all I have to do is I'm not going to worry about, I've gone into nothingness for a while here. I'm not doing anything for anybody and the place is kind of falling apart.
Good.
But I can push things aside.
Good.
And there's room for people.
Good.
Well, I'll bring something as in the snack variety tomorrow too.
Yeah. Okay.
And I remember.
I think I'll make a pebble.
David hit
a blueberry.
David had a great problem before he left. He would like to see the role of likeness and unlikeness and same and other as a key point. And
well,
it's
not that so much as I can't continue reading until I untie that knot of fishermen.
Yeah, that's why it's good to go
that
there.
That coil.
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
It's not coming together for me. I'll look at it again. I have to do some of my own work.
In the permitted issue you're talking, right?
Yeah. Okay, thank you guys. Thank
I'd you, offer Pierre. My house, but
pleasure.
It's outside.
Fun?
All right. Let me grab your microphone here.
Well, I have a heater, but it doesn't extend to everyone.
Does it bother you hanging from a pocket?
No. Probably not a bad thing. I have an orange one here. One of those yellow ones. Pardon yellow, me? Really bright yellow on that one sometimes.
Okay,
Okay.
So, see who this is. Because he's got a really distinctive voice.
So, and I'd like to keep it from just 8 until 10. Just 2 hours.
Sure.
Because I've got to get on with my day.
And David, I'm open, but it is early in the morning and